I've had this urge to just do music and be in the band, and all I wanted to do is, I saw these guys on stage when I would go to festivals, and I'd see my favorite bands like Taxi Violence, and I would just be like, that's what I want to do. I want to just play music, and it's such a great feeling. Basically, we heard that Eagles of Death Metal were coming to South Africa, and at first I didn't believe it. We've got like memories of us finishing school exams and like jamming to Eagles of Death Metal when we went out partying afterwards. Like, that's how, like, we properly loved them. And then when they were coming, we were just like, we have to meet these dudes. I was driving home and Murray was at the flat, and I heard on 5FM, phone in now and you can get backstage tickets to One Night in Cape Town. And I ran upstairs, I remember running upstairs and be like, phone 5FM now, phone 5FM now. So we phoned and both of us got the ticket right there. There was no like competition. It was just like, cool, you got it. You got backstage. So we were just like, ah! So we made a little package with like all of our like sort of imagery and CD and links and everything to our social media and stuff to him. And we met them backstage. I mean, it was so awesome. And then we just chilled and chatted to Dave, and we gave him our stuff, and he was so cool. He was just like, yeah, I'll put it backstage. I'll listen to it afterwards. Like 2 days later, he emailed us and was like, sweet, when are we doing the album? And it was just like, I remember going absolutely nuts. Just like, what the hell? How is that possible? I mean, it's like one of our favorite bands, like, ever. Dave said to us, you got to come to America. So we were like, oh my God, that's expensive. Like, to fly all of us there and then pay for the studio and the mixing artist and the engineer and, you know, and all that stuff just to get us there and do that whole thing. It just was going to cost a huge, and we added up the numbers. We were like, whoa, how are we ever gonna, we don't have any sort of sponsorship or anything right now.
We met with a couple of people and we started a Kickstarter project to try and raise the necessary funds to get to America, and managed to raise $25,000 in 40 days, which we didn't think was possible at the time, and we still didn't know how the hell that happened, but it happened, and we're going to America.
It's such a big thing to happen to like a band like ourselves. It's, you know, we're not a big established band yet now we've been given such a rad opportunity to like record an album in the States with a guy that's directly influenced our music from the start, pretty much.
So we'll see what happens, you know. If it all just bombs out and in 5 years' time we're still getting one person at our gig, you know, then you know that it's time to move on to something else. Start brewing beer or something.